Hello and welcome back once again to Infinite Jeff, the project where I, the man named Jeff, well, my name is Jeffrey, but no one calls me that. Except, well, actually that's not true. Some people only call me that, to which I call them by their full name, Jeffrey, Steven. But I go by Jeff, hence Infinite Jeff, where I read Infinite Jest, a book by David Foster Wallace, published in 1996. It's a big book. We are on to page 241 of this big book, and I'm just trying to knock these out before work. Get three of them done today. Three Jeffinigan's Wakes. This is two of three Infinite Jeffs. Page 241. Here we go. Monastery. The combined St. John's Seminary and offices for the RCC's Boston Archdiocese, partly in Upper Brighton, neither half-taxed. Convent headquarters of the Sisters of Africa. The National Craniofacial Pain Foundation, the Dr. George Roebling Runyon Memorial Institute for Podiatric Research, Regional Shiny Truck, Land Barge and Catapult Facilities for the ONN-subsidized Empire Waste Displacement Company, what the Quebecois call Le Trebuchet Noir, the Black Trebuchets, spectacular block-long catapults that make a sound like a giant stamping foot as they fling great twine-bundled waste vehicles into the subannular regions of the Great Concavity at a parabolic altitude exceeding 5 kilometers. The device's slings are of an alloy-belted elastic, and their huge cupped vehicle receptacles like catcher's mitts from hell. A half dozen or so of the catapults in this, like, blimp hangerish thing with a selectively slide-backable roof, taking up a good 6 square blocks of Enfield's branchiform incursion into the Alston Spur, occasional school tours tolerated but not encouraged, and so on. With the whole flexed Enfield tennis limb sleeved in a perimeter layer of light residential and mercantile properties. The Enfield Tennis Academy occupies probably now the nicest site in Enfield, some 10 years after balding and shaving flat the top of the big abrupt hill that constitutes a kind of raised cyst on the township's elbow, the better part of 75 hectares of broad lawns and clover-leafing paths, and topologically cutting-edge erections, 32 asphalt tennis courts and 16 hard-true composition tennis courts, and extensive underground maintenance and storage, and athletic training facilities, and briars and calliopses, and pines mixed artfully in on the inclines with deciduous trees, the ETA hilltop overlooking on one side east historic Commonwealth Avenue's elevated migration out of the squalor of Lower Brighton. Liquor stores and laundromats and bars and palisades of somber and guano-dappled tenement facades. The huge and brooding Brighton project high-rises with 3-story-high orange ID numbers on the sides, plus liquor stores and pale men in leather and whole gangs of pale children in leather in the corners, and Greek-owned pizza places with yellow walls and dirty corner markets owned by Orientals who try like heck to keep their sidewalks clean, but can't, even with hoses, plus the quarter-hourly trundle and ding of the Green Line's train's labor up the avenue's long rise to Boston College, into the spiky elegance of B.C., and the broad gentrification of Newton out to the west, where the haze-haloed Boston sun drops behind the last node of the 4-kilometer sine wave that is collectively called the historic April Marathon's Heartbreak Hill, the sun always setting 15 minutes to the nanosecond after DeLint turns on the court's high tower lights. To, I think it must be the southwest, ETA overlooks the steely gray tangle of Sunstrand's transformers and high-voltage grids and coaxial chokers strung with beads of ceramic insulators, with not one Sunstrand smokestack anywhere in sight, but a monstrous mega-ohm insulator cluster at the terminus of a string of signs trailing in. All right, that is page 241 of Infinite Jest. Yeah. I'm gonna take my leave. Good night.